कल्टीवेशन, प्रोटेक्टेड कल्टीवेशन ऑफ टोमेटो, बोटेनिकल नेम ऑफ टोमेटो इज लाइकोपर्सिकॉन इस्कुलेंटम, फैमिली सोलानेसी, एंड क्रोमोजोम नंबर ऑफ टोमेटो इज 2n इज इक्वल टू 26, एंड द नेटिव ऑफ टोमेटो इज द साउथ अमेरिका. व्हाई प्रोटेक्टेड कल्टीवेशन, व्हाई वी डन द प्रोटेक्टेड कल्टीवेशन, बिकॉज इट प्रोड्यूस बेटर क्वालिटी ऑफ फ्रूट्स, हायर प्रोडक्टिविटी, ऑफ सीजन वी कैन प्रोड्यूस ऑफ सीजन फ्रूट्स. टोमेटो कैन बी प्रोड्यूस इन ऑफ सीजन ड्यू टू द इफ यू अडॉप्ट द प्रोटेक्टेड कल्टिवेशन. देन वी कैन रिड्यूस द इंसेक्ट एंड डिसीजेस इन प्रोटेक्टेड कल्टिवेशन, बेटर इंसेक्ट एंड डिसीज कंट्रोल, एंड रिड्यूस द यूज ऑफ पेस्टिसाइड्स. देन इफिशियंट यूज ऑफ रिसोर्सेस, दैट मीन्स द efficient use of water and required of chemicals only use for tomatoes. That means the efficient use, require amount of material are used in protected cultivation only. That means the waste is the waste amount of material we cannot be used for the nursery raising and hardening of plants. For the protected cultivation, we can produce different types of materials, some of the nursery raising materials, and some of the after the raising of nursery the plants require hardening of so that's why that plant can be adopted in open environment. Introduction of tomato. India is the world fifth largest producer of tomato, accounting for 6% of world production. Okay, so the India rank fifth in largest producer of tomato. Tomato is the third most important vegetable of India by sharing 8.5% of total vegetable production. Okay, third most important vegetables of India, tomato. The total tomato production is 8.6 million tons and its productivity is 14 tons per hectare, which is half of the world productivity. Total production is 8.6 million tons and the productivity is 14 tons per hectare. It is half of the world productivity. Okay, so the productivity of tomato is highest in India. Orissa, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka are the major tomato growing states. Tomato Lycopersicum esculentum is an important crop of Solanaceae group, which with the potato, brinjal, and chili. Solanaceae group is a big group of under this family. In that one, tomato is an important crop of Solanaceae group. Then Sikkim is the gifted with suitable climates for the round the year tomato cultivation. It is cultivated in the open field during Rabi season and under protected cultivation condition during the summer and rainy season. So tomato can be grown throughout the year in the Sikkim. The tomato are grown in open field condition in Rabi season, and remaining rainy and summer season it is done in protected condition. The nutritive value of tomato. A ripe tomato contains as much as 93.2 to 94% of water, and it has a high nutritive value, being a good source of vitamins and minerals. The tomato contains 93 to 94% of water. Percents of water, and it is very appetizing and removes constipation and has pleasing and refreshing taste. So the tomato having a very refreshing taste, and it can be it can be removes the constipation, and it is very tasty for the as a use for the table purpose and also for the vegetable purpose. And the tomato also used for the processing purpose. Very delicious processing products are prepared from the tomatoes, are tomato soup, tomato ketchup, etc. Nutritive value of tomato is given below per 100 gram of edible portion, which may vary with the variety and climates. General figures of nutritive value of tomato is given per 100 gram. Okay. Energy kilocalorie 22 content, fat percent is 0.2%, and water 93% of water in 100 gram of tomato. Then 0.7% of fiber. Carbohydrates 3.6% and minerals 0.6%. 1.9% of protein in 100 gram of tomato, and vitamin A 320. Protected structures. Which protected structures are used for the cultivation of tomato under protected structure? The main purpose of protected cultivation is to create a favorable environment for a sustained yield, as to realize its maximum potential even in adverse climatic conditions. Okay, so protected cultivation is required when required for the adverse climatic condition. The protected structure may be high cost or low cost, poly house, net house, and tunnels. We have to see in different types of or different materials are used for the making the making protected structures. So low cost, and it may be high cost. So poly house, net house, and tunnels can be used for the cultivation of tomato. A partially ventilated low cost poly house with both polythene and agro shade net may be suitable for the farmer. Okay, if you have a shade net, we can also cultivate the tomato under a shade. Okay, this is called as partial ventilation or a partially ventilated low cost poly house. Okay, the site for the protected cultivation should be accessible, sunny, with no waterlogging condition. The site selection criteria for the construction of protected structure is to be it should be accessible and sunny with no waterlogging. Okay. To minimize the disease, new area should be selected for cultivation, and the soil should be well drained, loamy, with adequate organic matters less than 2%. Soil requirement for the protected cultivation of tomato is well drained, loamy, with adequate organic matter less than 2%. Crops are successfully grown in the moderately acidic soil, pH 6 to 7.5. okay, pH requirement 6 to 7.5, moderately acidic soil. The pH can be maintained by adding lime or dolomite at 100 gram per meter square. For maintaining the pH, we can add the lime or dolomite. Climate temperature, tomato prefers the moderate temperature and thrives well in the temperature range of 25 to 30 degrees Celsius. Okay. 25 to 30 degrees Celsius temperature required for the tomato cultivation under protected cultivation. The prevalence of low temperature and high humidity cause severe infestation of diseases. Okay, if the temperature is low and humidity high, is cause the diseases of tomato. So the protected cultivation, we can help for maintaining the temperature and humidity and reduces the disease infestation. Then nursery management. seeds are sown in a raised beds under protected structure. Seed can be sown about 25 to 30 days before planting. Okay, that means 25 to 30 days before the planting of tomato, the seeds are sown in the raised beds under protected structure. The average seed rate for the tomato is 350 to 400 gram per hectare. Okay, 350 to 400 gram of seeds per hectare. The seeds are sown with a row spacing of 10 centimeter and seed spacing of 0.5 centimeter. Densely populated seeds produce weak and lanky seedlings. Okay, so the spacing is 10 centimeter and seed spacing is row spacing 10 centimeter and seed spacing 0.5 centimeters. That means 10 by 0.5 centimeter spacing, planting distance 10 by 0.5 centimeter. The beds should be drenched with trichoderma plus pseudomonas culture at 2% to manage the damping off. The seedling disease is damping off. Tomato seedling disease is damping off to overcome this disease. We can use the drenching, that is drench with trichoderma plus pseudomonas culture at the 2%. Variety of tomato. Indeterminate tomato varieties are suitable for the cultivation under polyhouse. Okay, indeterminate varieties are mostly used for the cultivation of tomato under polyhouse. So the varieties are Avatar, Indam Hybrid, All Rounder, Arka Meghali, Arka Saurabhi. These are the varieties are suitable for the tomato cultivation. Okay, keep it in your mind. These varieties are Avatar, Indam Hybrid, All Rounders, Arka Meghali and Arka Saurabhi. Next one is the planting. Tomato should be planted on the raised beds with the bed width is 1.5 meter. Okay, bed size, width of bed is 1.5 meter. There should be a path 0.6 meter between two beds. Okay, for walking, for observing the seedlings. Okay, 20 to 25 day old seedlings should be planted at the distance of 1 by 0.8 centimeter before the planting. The root of seedlings should be deep for 15 minutes of trichoderma plus pseudomonas culture at 10%. Okay, planting distance is 1 by 0.8 centimeter. The seedling treatment given to the seedlings is with the dipping of seedlings for 15 minutes in a trichoderma plus pseudomonas culture at the rate 10%. Okay, to prevent the soil borne disease. Planting should be preferably done in a small pits for better root development. Nutrient management. The nutrient requirement of tomato is moderately high. Nitrogen 100 gram, phosphorus 60 gram. Nitrogen 100 kg, phosphorus 60 kg and potassium 60 kg per hectare. Okay. Nutrient requirement for the tomato is moderately high is 100, 60, 80 kg of NPK per hectare and shows the good response with the addition of nutrients. Then FOM should be applied at the rate 5 kg per meter square along with the neem cake at the rate 200 gram per meter square. Okay, FOM apply with neem cake. At the time of planting, seedling should be treated with azospirillium plus PSB 20% phosphorus solubilizing bacteria for 15 minutes. Planting seedlings should be treated with then the addition of vermicompost at the rate 1 kg per meter square further improves the production. Then vermicompost are also used for improving the production of tomato. Then intercultural and irrigation. Tomato is a shallow rooted crop and roots are restricted within 15 to 20 centimeters of soil. So light earthing up should be done after 30 days and 45 days of planting. Earthing up after 35 to 45 days of planting. Good quality water should be applied at 10 days interval, and the plant should be provided with strong multiple sticks after 1 month of planting. So this is the training of plants with the help of sticks. The stick is very important for the tomato cultivation. This is done after 1 month of planting. The diseases of tomato under protected cultivation is late blight. Late blight of tomato is the most devastating disease caused by a fungus Phytophthora infestans. Okay, late blight, this is fungus disease. They infect and destroy the leaves, stems and fruits. The infection is most rapid during condition of high moisture and moderate temperature, 20 to 35 degrees Celsius. If the moisture content is high and temperature is moderate, 20 to 25% degrees Celsius, the rapid infection may be occur. Management, nursery soil treatment with trichoderma culture at the rate 2%. Soil drenching with trichoderma culture 2% before planting. And seedling treatment with trichoderma culture at the rate 10% for 15 minutes. Okay, this is the management of leaf blight. Then tomato early blight. Early blight of tomato caused by the fungus Alternaria solani is a common foliar disease of tomato. And this disease causes a direct loss by the infection of fruit and indirect loss by the reducing the plant vigor. And this disease can be managed by spray of Bordax mixture 1:1:10%. Then gray molds, botrytis. Gray molds is a common and often serious fungal disease. Botrytis cinerea is an important disease of tomato, and infection occurs after flowering and fruit set. Okay, the gray mold occur after the flowering and fruit set. In case of severe infection, flowers and pedicels start dying, and in the late stage, fruit also start rotting. If the infestation is severe, the flowers and pedicel start dying, and later the stage fruits are also start rotting. The infection start from peduncle end, and infected fruits are not suitable for consumption. Okay, the management practices for the gray molds is application of Bordax mixture after 1 month of planting. In case of severe infestation, spray of Kavach, that is chlorothalonil at 1.5 gram per liter, minimize the infestation. Next one is the Septoria leaf spot of tomato. Septoria leaf spot is caused by fungus disease. Septoria lycopersici. It is one of the most destructive disease of tomato foliage, and particularly severe in areas where wet, humid weather persists of extended periods. This is also foliage disease, leaf spot. The disease spread upwards from the oldest or youngest growth, and the leaf lesions are numerous. The leaves turn slight yellow, then brown, and then wither. Root infection is rare. Management of leaf spot is remove the diseased plant, diseased leaf, and if catch early, the lower infected leaves can be removed and burned and destroyed. improve air circulation around the plants. If the plants can still be handled without a breaking them and stick or cage the plants to raise them off the ground and promote faster drying of the foliage. Mulch around the base of the plants and do not use overhead water. So this is the management practices of Septoria leaf disease. Do not overwatering, mulch around the plants, improve the air circulation around the plants, and remove disease leaves as early stage. The yield of tomato, on an average, the yield of tomato under protected cultivation, it may vary 6 to 8 kg per meter square if the proper care is taken. The average yield per plant may be 3 to 4 kg per plant, with the fruit number is 40 to 60 fruits per plant and fruit weight of 80 to 90 gram. Okay, this is the yield of fruit. 40 to 60 fruit per plant and the weight of fruit is 80 to 90 gram. Profitability. The cultivation of tomato is highly profitable. It is fruits are harvested between June or October. The cost of cultivation may vary from rupees 20 to 25 per meter square, while the earning may be between 100 to 130 per meter square. Okay, so the cost benefit ratio in tomato is generally as high as 1:4 in a protected cultivation. 1:4 cost benefit ratio. So this is all about protected cultivation of tomato.